Well, hi everybody, and welcome back to video number 2 in the Moodle Gradebook Training Series. In our last episode, we talked about the importance of determining your grading method in advance. That allows you to set your gradebook up quickly and accurately. Now, in this video, we're going to explain the category and items view. It's very important because it's what you use to give your gradebook structure. So, from our main Moodle page, let's come to the left-hand column, find course menu. There's the gradebook. Let's give it a click. And we're in the grader report. Okay, there's two ways to get to where we need to go. We can come to the upper left-hand corner, choose an action, use the drop-down, and there's categories and items with two options. I'm going to click away because under the word grader report, we have some tabs, and yes, there's categories and items, the second tab from the left. I'm going to click that one, and it takes us into the simple view for editing categories and items. Right under the tabs, you'll see full view. Let's give that a click so you can see all of it. Okay, the beige area surrounding the content is your class name. The blue area is a category, for example, quiz or field study. And then the white objects within the blue boxes are the actual gradable items. The name column, well, that's exactly what it is. It names what each item is: quiz, field study, tests, etc. In our last video, we talked about the different types of aggregation. We have sum of grades, simple weighted means of grades, and weighted. If you notice, this is set to be simple weighted. Now, I want to show you something. It says aggregation at the top, and right next door, we see extra credit. Okay, use your drop-down in the beige box and change to weighted means of grades. And when you do, we have a dynamic screen. Your screen has changed and a column has been added for weight. Weight is the value of that particular 25%. All right, if we have a 25% quiz value and we're using a weighted means of grades, we would add 25.0 into that column. And I see occasionally people will put 0.25. That's only a quarter of a percent. That would be less. Something else you should be aware of, when we go to sum of grades, and I'm going to change that in my beige area, notice we see extra credit, and it just turned the quiz category into an extra credit category. Be nice, but not likely. Uncheck that. In fact, sum of grades does not work with extra credit. Do not use sum of grades if you need extra credit. I'm going to go back. I'm going to change to sum of weighted means. Maximum grade is, in fact, the maximum number of points that you can get. You can set that, and we'll show you how as we build our assignments. The aggregate only non-empty grades column gives you a running total for the student's grades. Now, if the box is checked, Moodle is going to assume those empty grades correspond to assignments that have not happened, and so it will not include those empty grades when it does the calculations. But if the box is not checked, Moodle thinks all those empties are zeros and is going to calculate them into the final total. That's going to lead to screams of anguish and panic emails. My recommendation is always include aggregate non-empty grades. The next column is exactly the opposite. Aggregate including subcategories, major Moodle glitch. It's been reported, they're working on fixing it, but do not use this column. The drop the lowest column instructs Moodle to drop the lowest grade item in that particular category. For example, I'm coming down to the blue area of field study, and I'm going to drop one of the lowest grades, and in fact, that item appears. By the way, to make anything count, come to the bottom center where it says Save Changes. As you make your changes, make sure you save them, or you can spend all afternoon making adjustments, and it won't impact the gradebook. multiplicator and offset are only going to work if you enter the gradebook through the front page or the main page. If you come down to the bottom, you see the option to add a grade item. You can do it, but you will not have access to the multiplicator or the offset. Let's look in field study. First item in field study, created in gradebook, come across, and you'll see there is no input for those items, unlike the three items below it. So, it's kind of important, but what do they do? Well, the multiplicator column allows you to enter a number to multiply the grade item total by. For example, putting 2 in this column would double a student's grade for that particular item. It should always, of course, have at least a 1 in that column. The offset column adds the number input to a student's grade. For example, putting 5 in this column adds 5 points to every student's grade for a particular grade item. The actions, those are the things we came to grow and love, know and love actually, in the new teacher orientation videos. You can move your items if they end up in the wrong column. You can delete them. You can edit them. There's lots you can do. And the last one is selecting all or selecting multiple grade items at the same time. Well, that's a lot to digest, so take a few minutes and come back next time. We're going to start with a blank slate. We're going to add grade items and grade categories and show you how to put this thing together for yourself. If you have problems in between then and watching the video, you can always call us at 3633 or stop in at Library 315 because we are here to help.